Hi guys, 13 Diamond Creeper for you, and welcome back to another Minecraft video. Woohoo! Today we are reviewing one of the new snapshots for the 1.11, the exploration update. This is the next update for Minecraft. So this is snapshot 16W39C, and we're gonna cover some of the older snapshots too, of some of the older other features. But this is where I'm going to show you some bigger features, and I'm going to show you some of the smaller features. So let's get into the video, shall we? So one of the unique features I like, okay, let's get this helmet and this Electra, and we can put Electras on armor stands. That's pretty cool. Very cool, because I was wondering when they were ever going to add it, but they added it into this update, which is cool, so we can finally use them. And we can use them on, we can put them on armor stands, which is cool. And where are they? Oh, they were in my armor slot. Okay. There is a new enchantment. These are negative enchantments. These are the curse of binding. If you put it on your head or any armor piece, this is going to be rare loot. It means you can never take it off. That's not, that would not be good. And the curse of vanishing. Now, this you probably can figure right now is very bad, because if what happens if you kill yourself, everything normally drops, and I just died right there. Okay, and there we go. So I got my helmet back, but the sword vanished away. So that's a very negative enchantment there. That would not be good if you had the binding on your head. Otherwise, you'll be stuck with it. Otherwise, you'll be stuck. Or your armor would be stuck to you. There we go. Alright. Let's getting ready for the next feature, which is the Observer Block. This is a bug update detector from Pocket Edition. Now, as you can see, there we go. So as soon as we put a block there, the observer sent redstone. This is its input and this is the output, and I'll show you this is its input from here. So if we take out like a seed, a wheat seed, and put it back in, take it out, take it back in, you can see that the node blocks play. And if we do with the banner, you can do this with chests. You can open the chest, you can close the chest. And yeah, this is very cool. Very cool little pocket edition feature that got here, that came to PC finally. That's cool. And how to craft it is 6 pieces of cobblestone, 2 redstone, plus 1 nether quart, and then you got your observer block. This is pretty cool block. This is a unique block. I will probably do some experiments, see what I can come up with it, or see what I can do with redstone with it. That's gonna be pretty cool. And now up to the new feature. It's called the Shulker Box. And the Shulker Box, what you can do is it, and also it's another container in Minecraft. It's like a chest. There you go. So it can send comparator signals out, like that redstone lamp with the redstone comparator. It actually works. And if we push it by pistons, it will pop it off. And if we use a dispenser or a dropper, well, the dispensers will place it down, and the droppers will turn it into an entity. But as you see, everything was saved. If we pick it up. Nothing drops out, and everything's been there. And there is golden apples, that which is a stack of 64, and they can come in a whole bunch of different colors. They can go from white to red, black, green, any color you can imagine. Now, how to do this is I'm gonna put one of my shulker boxes in here, and you can use a red. How to do this is you can use your 2x2. You could put a shulker box right near a piece of any type of dye you want. Then you can get your shulker box, which is your different color shulker box. and I'll do it with these two. And it doesn't matter where they are placed, they can go anywhere as long as there's a shulker box and a piece of die, you're good. And you can get that, and there we go. We got our different colored shulker boxes, which are pretty cool. They can even go on the walls. So if you had like a wall that blends in, and perhaps that you have some sort of secret way of doing things, or storing things, like your diamonds or something, you can just open it like this. And put like a lot of white wool, or blend it in with something. So you can do things like that. And another thing, let's see here. We have another mob to the game. This is called the llama. And llamas spawn in extreme hills biomes. And you can tame them. And they come in varieties like this. And they come in varieties like a nice little brownish texture, which is cool. Once you tame one, you could put a piece of carpet, like a green carpet. You would get a creeper face on the carpet. And if you got like a purple one, you will get a Enderman face. And what you could do is you can have a chest, and you could store all your items and stuff in it, which is pretty cool. And one thing with the shulker box, you can't put a shulker box into a shulker box doesn't work that way, because you cannot make an infinite loop of shulker boxes. There, alright. So, what else features we got? Hold on, let me reset the time. Let's get the time back to day here. There we go. There we go. If we pull one llama along, the other two llamas follow, so they'll make a caravan. Let's pull them along here. There we go. You can see they make a caravan. So that would be very useful if you like to make a, you know, like a lot of chests, like a, put a lot, get a lot of llamas, tame them. You could have like a player, and you know, could sit on it for like a ride, and you could pull the llama along, and you can have a few other llamas to help you there, which is cool. Another feature with them is wolves. So wolves, what they'll do is wolves will start running away, and they'll spit at them, and I'll show you right in a second here. You can see the wolves are trying to run away, and the llama. Should spit at Han, and looks like I'm gonna have to do this in creative here. All right, hold on. no, yes, no, maybe so. Hold on here. Let's grab some lost spawn eggs. Let's go back into survival. Spawn one. Well, they're running away from the llama. But they're not spitting at the wolves. That's odd. That's okay, but the spit attack will deal one heart damage if you were in it, but the llamas don't spit at you, which is probably good. And once you tame one, like I said, once you tame one, let's tame one over here. Oh, they're kind of like horses. You have to have an empty hand. I'm gonna have to have the weather cleared. Here we go. There we go, it's taming. It's thinking about it. And now we're just going in circles though. Alrighty here, let's see what's going on now. What's a tame? Alright, well, we'll do this one again. So if we switch out the carpet, see, it gets a... There's a red, That looks pretty cool and unique. The brown. That looks really... Okay, that looks nice. Oop! There we go. We've got the orange, which is cool. And here is the purple, and there here is what lime looks like. So this is pretty cool. So there we go. We can replace it. There we go. And now we're gonna go to the next features of the update. Is first we'll go back into survival here because I like to do most of it this in survival. And by the way, in 1.11 also, hunger is been declined for most actions like running and things like that. And by the way, how to craft a shulker box, well, before I run off to the next features, which are very exciting ones, is how to craft a shulker box is grab 2 shulker shells and plus 1 chest, you get a purple or the default shulker box. Alright, there we go. Just pack some of these things up, and then we can head off to the next features. And there we go. I'll put this piece of grass in my inventory. All right. So let's find the right villager here. This is a cartographer. This is a brand new villager, and I'm gonna have to go in creative for this too a little bit, which is all right. So if we go into paper, there we go. Wait. Not creative. I need survival. There we go. Game mode. Oh, there we go. There we are. And if we trade with him a little bit. There we go. We trade with him. So you have to trade a certain amount of paper for an emerald. A compass for a emerald. And then there's 2 other stuff he will have. Or a few other things he'll have. So... There we go. Emerald 9 emeralds or how many emeralds you want for an empty map. So you can get maps and you can explore the end with them. And now these maps look a little different. These are the Ocean Explorer map and the Woodland Exploration map. So we're gonna get both of them. There we go. We'll just do it like this. There we are. And we'll get both of them, the Woodland and the Ocean Explorer map. There we go. So, what you see there, that little icon, and this leads you to an ocean monument. And the smaller the dot is, the more farther you have to go. So, I think the normal direction is north. So this would be north, and this would be going for the... Woodland Exploration map, and there's a cool dungeon in this in the Woodland Exploration map, and I'll meet you when I get there. Alright, I have gotten closer and closer. As the dot grows bigger, it means the closer you are. And look at what we found, the Woodland Mansion. So this is a new dungeon in the game. And you can find them by getting these Woodland Exploration maps. And for the same with Ocean Monuments, you could still find them with the Ocean Exploration map. So there's cool stuff in this. Very, 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 very cool stuff. And hold on, let me reload the world here. The chunks here. There we go. It's looking pretty good. So you can find, yeah, so these are located in dark oak forests, and look at that, it's all, look at that, it's in water too. All of it's on the, near an ocean too, that's pretty cool. First, before we do this, we're gonna have to grab a few blocks here. There we go. Alrighty, here, almost there, almost, there we are. So here is the front porch, and let's go inside. So we're gonna have to get, I'm gonna get my shield ready. So let's explore the mansion. So this is what it looks like. Nothing on the bottom of the staircase, but that's pretty cool. You can have a nice little... So here's a room with like a desk, a few flower pots with red tulips in them, which is pretty cool. And here is... Oh, this is one of the rooms I did not see ever. It is one of like the tree growing rooms, and has a bunch of dark oak saplings. Each one, and remember, each one generates differently. So this is the flower pot room. Over in this room is the mushroom garden, or the little mushroom growing area, and it has some coarse dirt, and with nothing in it, and the chest has nothing in it. Here is a storage room, and with a new one, this is called the Vindicator. This is one of the new mobs, and it's part of the Illagers. This is a new type of mob. And there's going to be another one called the Evolker, and I'll show you what that does later. They'll charge you with their iron axes. And what they'll do is they'll try to chop you down. And I hear some rains. I'm going to clear the weather there. And this is their storage room, but there's nothing in it. So, and there's a creeper. Oh, boy. Ooh, boy. And this place is pretty dark. So in here, this is like a little, like a nice quiet room, I guess. You can just like hang out in it. Maybe some little bit of the XP there. All right, so this is another room, another storage room, but with double chests, and there's nothing in there. Another mushroom growing place. Another mushroom garden. This is another quiet room. And another double chest room, which is pretty cool. And by the way, these Illagers also drop emeralds too, so that would be pretty useful if you like to have a little bit of villager trading. That would be pretty cool. Whoa! Whoa! Creeper! I saw a creeper in my face. Oh, boy. Oh, woo! That's pretty close. Here is another room. This is like some sort of... Oh! Not good. Oh! 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 Boy, boy, boy. Boy, boy, boy. Woo! And there's another mob. There's a skeleton. Alright, and there's another of those rooms, those staircase rooms. And there's one of those vindicators attacking me. Uh-oh. Oh! Ouch! That hurts. Oh! There we go. He is done for. Okay. Here's another of those staircase rooms. I think that's like a little... I don't know what they would call them. Okay, let's now go to the second floor. Okay, let's go up here. Go up here. Are there stairs? So let's go through here first. So this is like a wrestling match room, like over in this room over here. And there's some creepers. Creepers, skeletons. Oh boy. Okay, now they're going after each other, which is good, because that's a good opportunity for me to get in there. So this is like a little cage room. And there's some loot. Oh, ow. Let's get up here. So if you go up to the second floor of this room, and you open it, and look at that, you can find an enchant book, some string, even music discs. You can find some awesome loot in here. In this mansion. Got a nice little bedroom suite with a desk and a flower pot. If we go through here, here's some Illagers. And here's a new profession. These Evolkers. And these are Vexes, the flying ghosts. But they have an iron sword, and they'll charge after you. And the red, when they're red, that means they're gonna about to attack. And the Evolkers have two different attacks. One, he'll summon some Vexes. The other times, he's gonna do a fang attack. And I'll show you just a second here. As you just seen right there, that's his fang attack. And you can do that a lot. You can do that quite a few times if you aren't careful. And right there, he dropped the Totem of Undying. That's a new item, too. Oh, boy. You're getting smacked pretty quick. Those are the Vexes. And there's some spiders. And there's some law enemies. Woo! So those are the three new mobs. Oh. Okay, here we go. There we go. He dropped an emerald. Let's get the spider out of the way. Ooh, my. Ooh! All those Vexes and everything are really going after me. Okay, now let's go to the other wing of the second floor. Very nice views, too. Woo! Got out of there pretty quick. So here's a nice little library. This is like a little library area where everyone can study. Nice little area to work in. And there's no creepers in here. We'll be good. That's another of those library areas. And here's another room. This one has closets made out of dark oak doors, and this is the bed. If you go up to the second floor, there we go, we can find more loot, and you get efficiency 3 out of this one. And you got golden apples, string, name tags, bread, you name it. You can even find chainmail armor in this place too, which is pretty cool. And there we go, another library. Oh, a lot of libraries in this one. Here's another suite. It looks like a little restaurant they have in it, like when there's a lot of visitors and there's like, there we go, there's a lot, these Evokers, there's like 3 or 4, so you can get like a lot of Totems of Undying. Wow, I'm getting a lot of mobs after me. I'm gonna get rid of that skeleton. He's gonna annoy me the most, and I'm gonna get out of there. Probably the best thing. And I have my shield up. Okay, we're gonna take care of 2-1, right? Maybe? Not, okay. There we go. See, there's more of those Vexes. Whew, that was pretty brutal. Okay, we can put that carpet back. There we go. Okay, now we can go up to the third floor. There's 3 floors per mansion. And here we go. We got a little art of the Illagers. So there's here's a cat pixel art of a cat. I'm gonna eat another golden apple before I get whacked more with these guys. Here's another of those like cage rooms. And I'll explore more of them explore more of them. Let's see if I can find a ladder. There is no ladder. Are you kidding me, dude? Okay. Well, we're gonna have to. Come on, we're gonna have to find ladders. Hold on. Well, here's another room. This is like a map room. So this is like, I guess, their planning map. Like a map room of like where they built their mansion, probably. Which is pretty cool. Looks pretty cool. And I'm gonna turn off the weather before lightning strikes it. Because sometimes it can... Because you know how... You know, wooden lightning become fire. Alright, so in here is another suite with another another suite with different covers and pillows. And by the way, these Vexes don't drop anything. There we go. If we can explore more. What I should do is I'm going to find out the loot. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back in these. There we go. Those Vexes are going to try to. They're going to go after me. So I'm going to. Oh. Oh. Alright. We're going to build our way up. So we're going to use the iron axe that the Illager dropped. And oh boy. Not cool. And by the way, if you are running away, they can go right through blocks. Which means that they can chase after you. Ooh! Okay. So. There we go. If we go in here, we can find another golden apple, some gunpowder, some pumpkin seeds. You got bones, which are pretty cool, which is very convenient. We can drop down here. And there are two different types of pixel art. There are three types of pixel art. One is the chicken, one's the cat, and one's an illager. There we go. Let's go back down to the second floor. And yeah, this is a pretty cool place. Now I'm gonna explore a little bit more to see if I missed anything. There we go. I'm gonna take care of you. Hold on. Whew. Okay, that was not much of a problem that time. So let's see. I'm gonna go in spectator and I'm gonna find if I have anything else that I've missed. Let's see, so there's nothing over here. There's a lot of the mansion there. Let's go in the first floor, see if we forgot, missed anything. Let's see. There's some rooms that have jail cells, others have pumpkin melon gardens, which are pretty cool, or melon things, or melon and pumpkins, so that would be pretty cool. Let's see if we can find anything like that. And there's one of those other rooms. Let's see. Mostly all this stuff goes on the first floor, and the second floor is about mostly about where all the illagers or some of the illagers are, and that's where you'll find all the other different rooms. So there are very different variations of the mansion, because they're always generated differently. Each one is different, and I think they're kind of uncommon. But yeah, these are pretty cool structures here. And by the way, these are pretty cool dungeons. They really, these are very big things, very big dungeons, as you could see. But yeah, that is a pretty big feature, but you gotta be very, very prepared, because there's a lot of those traps and everything, and there's a whole bunch of chests and everything to find and to see what loot you get out of. But most of the time, there's a chainmail chest plate most of the time. So yeah, I think I've covered all the mansion, and I covered the exploration maps. Now I'm gonna go back and I'm gonna cover the next few stuff. All right, I am back to our starting point with all the shulker shells and everything. But now we're gonna actually see what's new with furnaces. So now you could put wool, carpet, and it's raining, of course. Hold on. Weather cleared. Okay. There we go. You can put bowls in it. Bowls in the furnace. Signs. Ladders. And boats. And then you have bows. Doors, wooden doors, not iron doors. We got all types of wooden doors. We got bows, fishing rods, all. So there we go. You can put any type of door in there. And there we go. It's almost done. We can put the bow and fishing rod, and then we'll be good to start off with we can go to the next feature, which will include creepers too. This was back in like the first snapshot of 1.11. So if we go in here, put a splash potion of water breathing. If he explodes, I'm sorry, Wolf. He'll leave a lingering effect. This lingering effect, so you can get into the cloud and get a potion effect. So how I did that was use a splash potion of any type of any type of potion, no matter if it was negative or positive, and I could do it with a couple more potions. I'm going to do this in the water here so it would not blow up the terrain here. Here we go. We can use strength. There you go. You got strength. And, whoa, yeah. And you can, now he leaves a strength cloud, or a strength 2 lingering cloud. And I better get, a golden apple here. Better get my golden apples. Let's see. Do I have them in the chest? And yes, I do. Very good. Whew. I need to eat some golden apples here before I get killed by these creepers. Whew. Now, I think that strength, I think if you add strength to a creeper's explosion, that might kind of makes sense. So if we use night vision, kaboom, he'll give you a night vision cloud. And if we lay down a creeper, and we'll give him a regeneration 2. There we go, he laid regeneration 2. Here we go. We're getting a lot of potion effects out of this too. And we got luck. So let's use luck on him. There we go. I got some luck on. And there you go. He laid down a luck potion cloud. A lingering cloud. So yeah. That's pretty cool now. So as I said, it doesn't really matter if it was negative potion effect or it was positive effect. It's any type of splash potion, and then he leaves a lingering cloud. So yeah, let's go on to our next feature. Okay, I am on top of this mountain, and it looks like we have really no way down, or we can go down. But what happens if we want to go straight down? We're gonna die. But nope, the Totem of Undying helps us. Now, what you just saw there with all the animation, whatnot, is when we fell, we would have been dead if we fell without the totem. You can put this in your offhand, or you can put this in your main hand. And what this does is, if you're at, down to your last heart and you got the totem, and what would happen is the let's say a creeper was killed ya, or a zombie, any type of mob in particular, this totem would easily restore it, and it'll give you regeneration 2 for around, I think, 20 seconds, and you got absorption, so you can have a little extra hearts, just kind of like golden apples, like the enchanted golden apples. There we go. So those are hearts on the top. Those golden hearts are on the top is absorption, which is pretty cool. And we got new spawn eggs. And I'm gonna go right back into creative here. And there's a couple new spawn eggs. And they've reorganized them from A to B, and this is what the first letter of what the mob is spelled. So in this case, we start off with B, which would be bat, and we end up with zombie villager. So we got a zombie villager egg, we got a spawn egg, and we got the new mobs over here. We got the Vex, well, the Stray, and the 1.10 mob. We got Squid, we got the... We got 1.9 mob over there. And we got... And we got the llama. And we got Husk. And let's see, I'm gonna dig out the ones that... And here's the Evoker from the mansion there. Undermite, got Elder Guardian, Donkey, Mule, Egg, Spawn Egg. So these were added in 1.10, but during the pre-releases, they took them out. But now they are back in 1.11, which is cool. And the Strain of Husk, I spawn in cold, and this spawns in the desert. This is these two mobs came in 1.10. But it's good that they added them back in. Now, we're going to go to the end because there's a couple things I want to show you and how to get the shulker shells and to show you some other cool little features with the end. But before we have to do that, you know, we have to locate a stronghold. Well, the easiest way to doing it is by Eyes of Ender, or if I have cheats enabled, I can do the /locate command and then I can easily find it. So I can do all the structures in Minecraft. So I'm going to teleport to that. So I'm going to go TP -4776. There we go. So that's another option over the Eyes of Ender if you want to, if you're a creative player. There we go. So we should press enter. We'll go in the spectator. And we should be good to go. There we go. Let's go down. And there we are. There is the stronghold. Now we just gotta find the M portal. And it is here somewhere. And if we go around here, let's see. Let's see here. Oh, there it is. And they portal ain't activated, but we always can activate it with our Eyes of Ender. There we go. If I can find creative there, I'll be good. Then we can activate all of the M portal frames. And there we go. There's another M portal nearby. There are 3 M portals. Or there is like 128 M portals in a single world, which is pretty cool that it was added in 1.9. Pretty useful when you have a lot of portals nearby. There we go. So if we go in through the end here, go in here, and we can, I'm gonna use the locate command again. I'm gonna do end city, and the closest one is, I'm gonna teleport to these coordinates, and I'm gonna teleport to 344. I'm going to go 100 blocks up, and I'm going to go -1,496, and then we should be there. Oops, and I add a equal sign. And there's the end, where's the end city here? Wait, hold on, let me look over those coordinates again. Oh, I didn't add the, there we go, we didn't add the negative sign there. There we go. Here we are in the end city, plus a little end ship over there, which is pretty cool. So you go into an end city and you find, you know where the shulkers are? It's those mobs over there. Over here, those little mobs that are acting like a block, those are the shulkers. So if, and they'll spit projectiles, and what they'll do is, okay, and I'm getting, oh, that's bad. Danger, danger. Throw up. Throw down an ender pearl. Oh, a totem of undying would be really useful here. Oh. Oh, boy. Can we do it? Oh. It saved us. Whew. Alright, so let's see. We'll get a shulker. Get that shulker. Where that shulker is on the edge there. So let's find a way. Let's go in. I'm going to give myself an. What I'll do is I'll look for a shulker quickly. Oh, if I could go back down. Whee! Oh, there is one. There is one right on top of me. Very convenient. We can just start teleporting our way up. We're gonna have health damage taken, so there we go. And there you go. There's the shulker shell. We just collected. Now we just gotta get this Enderman out of the way. Here we go. so we can go. There we go. Oh. All right, so let's go back down. Oh. Okay. Let's go down. And I need a pickaxe, but I don't have one on me. That's not good. So let's go up here. Let's break the block over here. Let's break another block. That's a pretty unique one too. You have to dig down to get to the entrance to it. Okay, so my original portal was a few hundred blocks back. So now I'm gonna look around and there should be an escape portal. Escape portals are found throughout the end, and this is a new feature. So what you can do is you can get back to the center of the end, because you can go thousands and thousands and thousands and hundreds of blocks away, and that sometimes it's a little difficult getting across all the as you travel farther and you get like all the cool loot from the end city, and I'll do that when I get to the end of my videos, to the end dimension, dimension in the, I don't know why the Electra is not working now. Probably spacebar is not working. It's all right. We'll find it. And there is one right there as we were trying to, as I was speaking about that. There we go. So yeah, these are escape portals. You can find them throughout the end. And if you're very, very far away, and you can see how far I am from where my normal portal would have been, because it's all the way out there. So we can easily go through here, and I can go right back to the center of the island, which is pretty cool. So we can go back. There we go. We're back, and where we started. I'm gonna turn the time back to day, just one more time. Okay, so we covered just about everything, I think, because yeah, pretty good. So we covered all the, here we go, all the enchantments. There's been some bug fixes, and this is the C version of 16W39C. So that's very good. So they fixed the Electra textures, because in the last two snapshots ago, it would be buggy where it had items on it. Now it's flying. It's pretty cool. There we go. So there was some bugs. There was a lot of bugs were fixed in this update. So that is all I got for this snapshot video. So if you really, really like the episode, please hit the double like button. I know there's no such one, but anyways, if you really liked the episode, please hit the comments button, share for a like it, that's okay by me. Subscribe to the channel if you'd like to see more videos like this, you'll see them on our homepage. And if you subscribe, that'd help out the channel a whole bunch. And if you have any future suggestions for any of the future episodes or anything future for the channel, you can leave them down in the comments box below if you have any suggestions. So that is all I got for this Minecraft episode, our Minecraft snapshot video, and I'll catch you next time. Bye-bye.